Welcome back to Dr. Sucheta's interactive class. Today we'll see the extension of particular TLC technique, that is thin layer chromatographic technique. The advanced version of thin layer chromatographic technique is high performance thin layer chromatographic technique. Here I have explained you this technique taking into consideration one of the example or considering this technique for method development of a particular organic bioactive molecule, standardization and validation of bioactive molecule utilizing HPTLC technique. Now there might be a question in your mind, why we need to standardize herbal drugs? Why we need to standardize herbal drugs? Which are the methods available? So TLC method, we have seen that it will give me phytochemicals, alkaloid, presence of alkaloids by carrying out TLC. Okay, now if suppose one of the plant is medicinally having very high value, for example tulsi is the plant which is having very high value as a medicinal value. Now which part of this tulsi plant, whether leaves, flowers, stems or root, are having very high bioactivity, it need to be find out. So when the assigned drug of tulsi plant is given in the market, the leaves of the plants are highly useful. Okay, but along with leaves, its stems, flowers, roots, if added as an adulterant, it does not actually affect the drug property, but it will decrease the effect of the drug. So this particular technique will be utilized to find out actual concentration of one of the bioactive molecule from that particular herbal drug. Now herbs can be part of the plant, whole plant. It can be made in powder, and the formulations are made by utilizing these part of the plant. So combination of parts of the plant or a single part which is highly useful matters a lot. So standardization involves involves the calibrated apparatus and documented methods utilizing reference standard. That means considering tulsi plant again, from that leaves, one of the organic ingredient is highly effective that acts as a standard reference over here. Okay, when I made the extract of tulsi leaves, it will contain that particular ingredient. The concentration of ingredient, how much it should be for particular amount of the sample, it is quoted and known. So we can compare that data by carrying out the standardization process. So there are number of ways we can standardize any herbal drug, like physical method, macroscopic, microscopic, botanical method, shape, size, organoleptic methods like color, texture, test, biological methods where microbial contamination, pharmacologist value, toxicological values, analgesic, bacterial, fungal values, physical, whether it is moist, ash, foam, its extractive values, its fluorescence analysis, and here the chemical analysis where we can do qualitative HPTLC fingerprinting. DNA finger, like your DNA fingerprinting, it is HPTLC fingerprinting for a particular plant. And quantitative analysis, again by utilizing HPTLC as one of the technique from chromatography. We'll see. In case of thin layer chromatography, we cut down the ready-made TLC plate and form the TLC plate, mark the baseline with the pencil, apply with capillary spotter the sample, components, the mixture given to you, develop that TLC plate and carry out detection. So you have to go in this pattern 1, 2, 3 and 4. So detection chambers are available for over here. If the color components, you can carry out the detection. Now same process we can carry out by high performance thin layer chromatography, that is HPTLC, where the process differs in application of sample over the plate by utilizing automatic sampler. Here known amount of solute dissolve in known amount of solvent as a mixture of solute is inserted through syringe, and the syringe has been programmed as a spotter over the plate, which will give amount of the spotting is defined over here as 2 microliter, 3 microliter, 5 microliter over the plate. So automatic sampler is key point in case of HPTLC. This plays very important role. And development of chromatogram, that is, once we have put this plate in chamber and dried, further analysis of this particular plate is done by densitometer scanning. You are scanning each and every spot with respect to its concentration on plate after separation, that particular process. These two points carry out qualitative and quantitative analysis. Purity and the accuracy of the method has been extensively increased by utilizing HPTLC method. So you have to selection of chromatographic layer over here, standard solution preparation, pre-washing of plates. Sometimes they carry out pre-washing of plate or keeping the plate in oven, which make it more active. You activate the plate by heating the plate in it, or if any material has been adsorbed over the plate, it will get removed at high temperature. So this particular process makes plate activation, or in other way, it also removes the impurity over the plate. So these are the steps involved, which again increase the quality of analysis. This is a Linomat application sampler. Just now I have explained you. After application of sample, chromatographic development is carried out in twin through chamber. You can see at the base there is a trough. You can see the groove at the base. So on that groove, there is a groove where you can put the TLC plate exactly perpendicular to the movement of the solvent. And on this groove, front and back side, the solvent is filled with the solvent, mobile phase, mixture of mobile phase, and this chamber is saturated with respect to 15 minutes, 20 minutes, 25 minutes, depending upon type of method development. You have to carry out ruggedness and rapidness of the method, reproducibility of the method. So you have to check for time in different time interval the development of chromatogram too. Here you can carry out the detection of spot or scanning and documentation part electronically over computer software. You can carry out all these things. You can take the photograph of that particular TLC plate for further analysis. Here I have considered one of the example, which is part of my research, where Cachia auriculata, this is particular plant which I have collected, and its medicinal values are very high. So from that particular leaves I have collected, and I am analyzing with even all parts of the plant are useful. I am studying here the leaves of the plant. From that particular leaves I have isolated one of the bioactive molecule, that is imodin 138 trihydroxy 6 methyl anthraquinone. This is having very high antioxidant potential, free radical scavenging potential, which was carried out by DPPH assay and NO assay. It shows potential effect with respect to antimicrobial reagent, and it is known anti-cancer agent. So I have just tried to develop the HPTLC method for this particular imodine bioactive molecule, where instrumental chromatographic condition you need to develop or give. So pre-coated silica plate of Merck 60 F2254. So this is the wavelength utilized, thickness of the plate, size of the plates, mobile phase you are utilizing. You just check over here 6.4 as 3.5 as 0.1 ml. In terms of ml, you have to see the ratio. Lamp utilized for detection is deuterium. Wavelength is 437. Now why this wavelength? So this particular compound shows higher absorbance at this particular wavelength. So you need to scan your plate at your maximum absorbing wavelength of the compound. Application mode, that is automatic TLC sampler, twin through chamber for development mode, scanner, TLC scanner, CAT software, temperature conditions, relative humidity and RF value. for this compound, known reported value should be known to you. And here after analysis, I have quoted all these details with RF value. This is the pictorial photo you can obtain from during the analysis, where this is the baseline where the automatic sampler has applied the sample, not in the form of circular spot, but you can see the sample has been applied. The syringe will go front and back to apply whatever microliters are there, that will apply and obtain as dotted lines over here. After separation, you can see these are the spots obtained for my compound in my sample. So these are the different solvent extract of leaves, stem, and the standard which I have spotted at the center of the plate with variable concentration, and at last the extract of flower. So I have compared here what is the concentration of this particular compound in leaves, stem, and flower. This is again the photographs you can get from the computer software, where the spot has been quantified with respect to peak at particular wavelength. So standard, this is for standard, and this is standard, and this is for in the mixture. So at this particular wavelength, how much mixture will contain. So this is the calibration plot. You will obtain whatever the spot you have spotted at the center, 5 spot. From that you will get calibration curve, and for every particular mixture from this particular spot and area under the curve, you can calculate the concentration. So the validation parameters I have quoted over here as the spot I have applied 1 to 5 micrograms. See, the amount of sample you are applying on the plate is very, very small in terms of microgram. Regression equation, that is from calibration curve, you will get that equation. Correlation coefficient, that is the R value, it should be near to 1.999 is acceptable value. Molar absorptivity, you have learned this concept in spectrophotometry, A equal to epsilon VC for particular compound, the molar absorptivity value. You can find out that molar absorptivity value. Limit of quantification you can calculate. Limit of detection you can calculate by utilizing this particular method. And these are the values for the mixture of compounds, mixture of plant parts, their extract, which were compared with the calibration curve, and utilizing that equation found out the values with microgram per gram. So you can see over here that if I use these plant parts are adulterated, then I can find out that if you are using leaves, it will contain high concentration of particular this imodium contained, and if they have used as an adulterant of stem, definitely I can find out the from the concentration the adulteration in my given Ayurvedic drug. Conclusion: this particular process you can apply pharmacognosical analysis of medical herbs, which is a very challenging issue for analytical chemistry, as herbs are very complicated system of mixtures. Developed method is highly sensitive, reliable for quantification of imodium, and this data you can utilize as an QC standard, quality control standard. Thank you. Hope you have understood this HPTLC technique, and for further details, hope you have understood this particular technique. Please like, share, and subscribe this video.